Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name is David and this is a magic review. Hey, today we're back in my magic library and we're going to look at Decode. This is Decode Red. It's by Risky Nanda and World Magic Shop. Risky Nanda, if you don't know, he also did Optical, he did RISC-4, he did Jump Ink. Okay, this DVD, however, it's not hosted by Risky. There is some footage of him at the end, but this DVD is hosted by John from World Magic Shop. the plot of this is a moving ink effect. So basically, the spectator is selecting a card and returning it, and then you're using a second card as kind of a notepad, and you're writing your prediction on the card and then showing it to them. And then explaining that it's in code and it needs to be decoded. And so you show the spectator the code written on the white of the card, and then they obviously can't understand your code and say you say it's really simple to decode this, and you shake it or you flick it, and they watch the ink transform from the code to their written selection. And then you're able to hand that selection out and give it to them, and they can keep it as a souvenir. So in the box, what you're going to get is you're going to get the DVD. It's in a cardboard sleeve. You're going to get the DVD on one side, and then you're going to get your gimmick on the other side. So a couple of questions that we always ask of all of our effects, the first of which is, can it be done surrounded? I think so. There really aren't any angle issues on this. I wouldn't have people behind you, and that's just kind of a no-brainer when you do some card effects. I think from behind is probably a bad place, but I think with the right handling, you could do it from almost a three-quarter circle all the way around. So pretty close to being completely surrounded. Can it be inspected? There really won't be anything to inspect in this effect. I think once you hand the card out to the spectator to let them keep as a souvenir, that's pretty much all they get to inspect. And so your part of the gimmick, your part of the gaff, that utility, that's secretly kept with you, and so if you do it right, they should never see that. Is it well made? Hey, this is actually really well made. It is a really well made gimmick. I've got a lot of these type of funny moving gaff card things stuff, and you do get to see the poorly made and the things that are well made. This is really well made. I like it. How much practice does it require? Very little. You're going to have to know how to do a card force, obviously. You're going to have to know how to do a top change or some sort of way to, give the spectator the souvenir, the take home. But other than that, there isn't really much practice. How much setup and reset is there? Very little. You could probably get back into this effect pretty easily, especially if you had some cards in your pocket that were ready to go for another performance. So very little setup. Positives. Positives for this, very fast, very visual. You don't need to make a new gimmick every single time. Risky Nanda, what he does is he gives you instructions at the end of the DVD on how to make your own if you wanted to make more. So that's great. I love it when the creators share that knowledge with you. They don't keep it to themselves. And he puts that together for you so that if you wanted to, if your gimmick got old or worn over time, you could in fact build another. You wouldn't have to buy this all over again. So that's good. Negatives. There's always negatives with every magic effect. These are just my negatives. They don't have to be yours. The negatives for this is it's always going to be the same card that you write the prediction on, right? Obviously. And it's probably always going to be the same force card. So that's just something to think about. You might want to have a couple of those in reserve. Might want to buy a forcing deck just so that you have multiple copies of the same card to force and to give out. Otherwise, you're going to go through new decks every single time because you're going to be giving out the same card every single time. So those would just be my negatives. Who would like this? Street magicians for sure. People that like edge style magic, people who are looking for something new. This is, like I said, I haven't seen this before, and so I think that's what sets this apart maybe from some of the other effects out there. So one tip, this is just for me. And I'm just putting that out there. I don't really like the code aspect of this effect. I think it's kind of awkward to write a code on a card and say, "Oh, you don't know what this is? It's a code." I think a better way to do it, and this is just my personal opinion, would actually be to write the wrong prediction on there. Because I think if you write letters that are familiar to the spectator, say you wrote three of clubs. You'd say, "Hey, I wrote your prediction, and it's the Three of Clubs." And they say, "No, it's not the Three of Clubs." And you go, "Oh, it's not? Well, I can take care of that." And you flick it, and it turns into the right prediction. I think that would go over farther, and then you don't need to explain the whole, "Oh, it's code that only I can understand, and I'm going to transcribe it for you." Another reason is the gimmick itself has some third dimension to it. It isn't completely flat, and I think in the right lighting or the wrong lighting, it could be obvious that it's not a flat card. And so maybe if you wrote thickly with black marker over some of those lines, the Sharpie marker would help disguise some of those markings in performance. And again, that might not make sense to you, but it will if you purchase Decode. So yeah, that's my review for Decode by Risky Nanda and World Magic Shop. And if you'd like to purchase your own, you can always find it at your favorite Murphy's Magic suppliers. Thanks. Bye.